Michael Douglas, this is a little bit special. Thank you very much for speaking with me. How are you?
I'm good, Georgie. Did you go to the F1?
I did. I was there reporting on it.
Good for you. Good for you.
Are you a big F1 fan?
I am. I am a big F1 fan.
Who's your team?
My team is Aston Martin. I'm an old McLaren supporter, but Aston Martin. I know you're on whatever team Daniel Ricciardo is a member of, I think is probably your choice.
You'd be right. We do love him. But hey, Michael, in preparing for this interview, I just kept being told that you are the greatest man in Hollywood. That is how people described you. How does that title sit with you?
My hearing isn't perfect, but I thought you said the grayest man in Hollywood. Greatest, I don't know about. That's very kind. I have not heard that necessarily, but I try to use my celebrity in some ways that make the world a better place. I don't know what other use there is for me to be here other than that. So that's nice to hear.
Well, congratulations on the new series, Franklin. What made you want to dive into the 1700s?
I've never done a period picture. Everything I've done in my career has been contemporary. And I said, wow, this is a true story, and this is a great concept, because the reality was, if Franklin failed in getting the support from the French, we would not have America. Congress has sent me here as a representative of the United States to elicit France in our war against England.
A real theme throughout this whole project is patriotism and Franklin struggling with the concept of what America means to him. What does America mean to you right now?
I review it economically strong, politically very vulnerable. In our country today, the two parties arguing with each other to kill each other. They just want to destroy the other party rather than looking forward to how can we protect this system, which is under attack. And so I think it's very important for us to realize how valuable elections are.
Grandfather, how long must we stay?
Until we win France to our side, or we are hanged.
Is there a third choice?
What was it like to film at the Palace of Versailles?
That was a dream. It was a dream come true. We film in Versailles on Mondays when Versailles was closed to the public, so we had access to the whole place. And of course, you know, Paris for 8 months is not bad.
Not bad at all, not bad at all. You talk about the international flair of the cast. Previously, I believe that you have said that Australians, Aussie actors are taking American roles because they're just the best when it comes to masculinity and portraying that. Do you still feel that way? And if so, what makes us so tough?
Well, you really did your homework, huh? Australia fights above their weight in so many areas. Is Margot your latest import, I think, that we have?
Yeah, she's sparkling, yeah.
And again, you know, spectacular job. The Aussie guys are, I think they lead the world in testosterone.
It's a beautiful day. Mikey D?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it a beautiful day?
Gorgeous day.
Now, you and your gorgeous wife, Catherine Zeta-Jones, you've been married now, I think, for 24 years. Michael, I'm actually due to be married at some point in the future. What advice do you have for me? What makes a happy marriage?
Happy wife, happy life.
I knew it.
Simple as that.
She did put a post up on Instagram recently and she referred to you as Mikey D. Do you call her Kathy Z?
No. Mikey D goes back a long time, even before I met Catherine. I don't know. Mikey, that's what they call a McDonald's hamburger, Mickey D. My friends call me Mikey.
Thank you so much for this chat. It's been wonderful.
Thank you so much. Appreciate you.